In this tutorial, we'll explore the simplest method for utilizing chroma key along with optimal settings. We're currently in design mode, and on the left side, you'll find the chroma key tab divided into four distinct sections. Key, spill correction, pre-process, and post-process. Before we move further, let us understand the basic chroma parameters. Key color selects the color to key out. Exclude removes the specific colors from key range. Gamma adjusts luminance. Density changes key color intensity. Matte defines the key color range. Threshold sets a cutoff value. Pre-process adjusts the color balance before chroma keying, changing the original video's appearance. Post-process fine-tunes brightness, contrast, and saturation after chroma keying for the perfect finishing touch. Right now, we have a recorded video coming from the local disk. You can also take live input and NDI source. If your video contains unwanted elements surrounding the anchor or subject, you can remove them by selecting the mask option in texture mode and adjust it. Now move to Chroma Keyer tab. Double-click to choose the key color, ideally opting for the darkest shade available. Switch to composite view and you will see that 90% of the work is already done if the lighting is correct and we get a good chroma background. The leftover part is fine-tuning for shadows and spills. Adjust the density until it no longer affects the subject. This is how strong the main color you're removing is. Higher density means it's more obvious and easier to remove. To fine-tune the chroma, switch to live matte mode. Black sets the min value to set the starting range of black color value of the video input. White sets the max value to set the extent of white color value of the video input. Suppress reduces the alpha of the chroma area after the black and white color range is set. Switch back to composite mode. To reduce the color spill from the subject, reduce the spill value. Note that if the chroma color is blue, we will need to increase this value. Use the post-process values to correct the final chroma video and match with your virtual set environment. You can also save the chroma presets with the specific name and access them later. There you have it, with the right setup and these chroma keying techniques, you can create stunning videos with limitless creative possibilities. Experiment, have fun, and unlock your imagination.